shall give the word to Pierre Caz. Pierre Caz was the right hand of Jean-Paul Benzekri during many years in the University of Paris, and he knows many, many things about correspondence analysis.
I thank Jérôme Pagès for this invitation to speak here at CARM. I will do some comments on correspondence analysis, the outline. I will speak of data analysis as an experimental chance, of the laboratory of statistics of University Paris since the 17th of coding, of correspondence analysis as a particular case of other methods, of correspondence analysis and modeling techniques, and correspondence analysis and data analysis very quickly since 2000s. First, data analysis as an experimental science. Theoretical results have been discovered and demonstrated after having been observed on the computer listing as an experience in physics. In this, inertia rates, contributions, test value, etc., have been set up to validate the results as the error computations in physics. Coding techniques allows defining the ad hoc table to be analyzed and the succession of the analysis, descriptive, explicative, or decisional. Analysis to be done to treat the data. This problem is analogous to the setup of an experiment in physics. I come back on the first and third point. Example of results discovered and demonstrated after seen on listing. In correspondence analysis of a contagion table crossing two sets I and J, inertia moments of factorial axis of the clouds and I and NJ associated to I and J are equal. Result which is now very standard, Brigitte Escoffier in his PhD. Other result seen on the listing, correspondence analysis of a doubling table of 0 and 1 as an total inertia equal to 1. Correspondence analysis of a doubling table of 0 and 1 is equivalent to normed principal correspondence analysis of the non-doubling or initial table. Furthermore, the eigenvalue in correspondence analysis is the eigenvalue in the normed principal correspondence analysis divided by the number of variables. Then we find again that the inertia in correspondence analysis of a table of 0 and 1 is equal to 1. The representation of lines are proportional in space, in factorial space. Before speaking coding, I will speak of the Laboratory of Statistics of University of Paris 6 in the 17th. Professor Benzekri was the director of the laboratory and also responsible of the Mr. 2 of statistics, Mr. Of research, with 150 to 200 students, the greatest M2 of France. 40 PhD defended each year since 1974, three or four defense each Monday in May and June. Example of application were very numerous and diversified: biology, ecology, economy, geology, linguistics, medicine, physics, psychology, sociology, etc. The diversity of students were very great: French, of course, African, Argentinian, Greek, Egyptian, Iranian, Greek, Libanian, Syrian, Turk, Vietnamese, etc. Consequence, great discussion, numerous ideas, expressional impact of the laboratory, publication, colloquium. Publication, I cite only publication of Professor Benzekri. In 1976, creation of the K-analysis des données, which have been numerized by NUMDAN at the end of 2010, but is not today in line. Publication in 1973 of the two famous books on data analysis, l'analyse des données. Publication in 1982 of the book Histoire et préhistoire, l'analyse des données. and after publication of the 5 books of the collection Pratique d'analyse des données. The first books are theoretical and the last third are applied to linguistics, medicine and economy. Colloquium were very friendly and productive in numerous French universities starting in 1970, Besançon, Marseille, Nice, Rennes, Larbrel, Nyon, etc. I come back to coding, usual coding, doubling of a table of data, nodes, ranks, 0 and 1, complete disjunctive coding, fuzzy coding, in particular barycentric coding at 3 or R modalities of a quantitative variable, coding allowing to get rid of the subject personal equation when the subjects give a certain number of nodes, we have a coding different for each individual. An example of coding for the NTF table or importation expansion table, a table where I equals G. Example of the importation exportation table, key IG is the total of importation from the country I towards the country G. To treat this data, you do correspondence analysis of the table KIG, KGI, juxtaposition of the table KIG and is transposed. This allows to add on one land I all the exchanges of the country I towards the country G, importation and exportation. The agonizer suggests doing correspondence analysis of the following table. Analysis is equivalent to do correspondence analysis of the mean exchange table and factorial analysis of the flux table with the ponderation given by correspondence analysis of the mean exchange table. Other techniques of coding, use of supplementary passive or illustrative elements to refine the interpretation that appears in the ternary table, for example, in certain procedures like discriminant analysis or scoring, etc. Coding allowing obtaining the equivalence with other analysis, case of principal composite analysis. We have a table X, we cross N individuals with P variables. Principal correspondence analysis of centered X is equivalent to correspondence analysis of the doubling table Y and is any real positive value and between the eigenvalue in correspondence analysis and principal composite analysis we have the relation which is given at the end of the slide. And here also, we have a representation proportionnel of the lines on factorial space in the two analyses. Term of y can be negative, then eigenvalues in correspondence analysis of y can be greater than 1. If a square is superior or equal to lambda bar, the mean of eigenvalue in principal correspondence analysis of x, all the eigenvalues in correspondence analysis are inférieur to 1. Cas particulier, Brigitte Escoffier, 1979, if the variable of X are also reduced, we have a principal correspondence analysis which is normed, and it's equivalent to correspondence analysis of Y, and Brigitte Escoffier has taken A equal lambda bar equal 1. Second, analyse with respect to a model, Brigitte Escoffier, 1984. Comparison of a frequency table, FIG, with reference table, MIG. To do this, we analyse the difference of these two tables with the ponderation given by correspondence of FIG. If MIG has the same margins than FIG, the present comparison is equivalent to the corresponding size of the table FIG minus MIG plus FI FG. Cas particulier, particular case, excuse me, intra-class analysis, I or J, is partitioned in subset. If I and J are partitioned the two in subset, we have the double intra-class analysis or internal analysis. Generalization can be done when partition I represented by graph. Correspondence analysis has a particular case of other methods. We have a table K IJ crossing two qualitative variables, X and Y, I and J, sets of modality of X and Y respectively. This is very classic that correspondence analysis is a double factorial analysis of profile lines and profile columns. It is also the canonical analysis of the two subspaces WX and WY, respectively spanned by the indicator variables of modality of X and Y. Indeed, this way of thinking corresponds to the research of the optimal coding, in fact the factors, centered and reduced of X and Y. Correspondence analysis, as underlined by Ludwig Lebar, can be considered as a double discriminant analysis. The first analysis, the variable to be explained is the qualitative variable Y, and the explicative variables are the indicator variables of X. The second analysis, it is the same, exchanging X and Y. Correspondence analysis corresponds also to the inter-battery analysis of Tucker of the table TX and TY, respectively associated to the indicator variables of X and Y, with the weight diagonal matrix given by the margin of KLG. Multiple correspondence analysis of the complete disjunctive table associated to Q quantitative variable X1 is Q is a particular case of the generalized canonical analysis of Carroll, where the associated subspaces are respectively spanned by the indicator variables of X1, X2. Multiple correspondence analysis is also equivalent to factorial multiple analysis of Escoffier pages of the complete disjunctive table because the ponderation of each subtable are equal to one in this case in factorial multiple analysis. Correspondence analysis of a subtable of BERT crossing two subsets of questions can be considered in many different ways as multiple coinertial analysis. Correspondence analysis is also a double principal competence analysis on instrumental variables. This possibility of correspondence analysis to be a particular case of numerous methods that implies its great importance in theoretical as well as practical point of view. Now, I come to correspondence analysis and coding techniques. The reconstitution formula can be considered as a coding technique. We have here the reconstitution formula, where T is the number of non-null eigenvalues. If we keep the R first factor, we have the least square approximation of order R, Fij star of Fij. The summation goes from 1 to R and not from 1 to T. If we take the logarithm of Fij star and near independence, we have approximately this equation, which corresponds to the log linear middle, log de Fij star égale mu plus alpha I plus beta j plus gamma ij. And alpha I, beta j, and gamma ij are given in the equation. The term of interaction, if r equal one is reduced to a multiplicative interaction term. We can notice that the absence of iteration corresponds to the independence, which makes that the log linear model present little interest when we have only two variables, except if modeling the iteration term. We will give two examples. In the first example, r equals 1. If only one factor seems sufficient to explain the data, and if the modalities of the variables that we cross to obtain the table Fij are ordered, and if this order is respected or nearly respected on the first factorial axis, we can do hypothesis of constant spacing between adjacent modalities on this axis. We can also suppose equal value for two near modalities on this axis, and therefore in space because we are the data are well represented on the first axis. This is equivalent if we suppose equal value for two near modalities, to pool these modalities and therefore to cumulate the two lines or columns associated. Thus, one obtains a more sophisticated model than the initial method of correspondence analysis, where the parameters are estimated from correspondence analysis under constraint. This is equivalent to fit using the least square method. An example of such approach is given by Gutmann to study the link between the mental state and the socio-economical status of the parents. In the previous modeling, Gutmann used to estimate the parameters either the least square method, which corresponds to correspondence analysis, either the maximum likelihood method, and he proposed some tests to validate the proposed models. Second example, where r equals 2, worsted 1987, the user table cross a set of 9 suicide modes with a set product of the sex by the age. Cut in 17 classes, we have 34 modalities in total. The first axed factorial opposes man and woman, while the second axis seems to show for each sex a linear effect of edge. The log linear associators is given here, where x, when I equals 0 for a woman and 1 for a man, x to I equals k for a person of HK. Correspondence analysis has an intermediate step in coding problem. Like any factorial analysis techniques, correspondence analysis acts as a data compression method before the modeling phase. This allows, in particular, to take in account the multicollinearity of data. Furthermore, the simultaneous use of correspondence analysis and the model allows having two complementary use of the data, and this can allow refining the modeling. We will only quote three examples of the common use of correspondence analysis with other statistical methods in the modeling problem. First example is the mixture of distribution. Q is the probability law estimated, for example, by an histogram Y. P, M are new probability laws. Beta M are unknown proportion to be estimated, and the beta M are positive and of some 1. If you call YI, well, the equation in the total mean of YI is the sum of beta M, PMI, with YI is the frequency of class I of histogram Y, and PMI, probability of class I of histogram Y for Lau PM. And we have a regression model with the constraints that the coefficients of beta are positive and to sum equal to 1. Present problem is very badly conditioned. Regression with constraint is not always good. The solution is to do correspondence analysis of X, the phase of compression. Regression with constraint on force factor of correspondence of X and after calculation of beta by transition formula. Second example, very classical problem of scoring. It is a classic problem. Forcing the class of an individual, good or bad player, alive or deceased, as a function of explicative variables, qualitative and quantitative. This is equivalent to explain the variable Y with two modalities. Numerous methods, discrete method of Saporta, barycentric discriminant analysis, Nakash and Alteri, other methods, logistic regression, regression tree, etc. I will compare here discrete method and barycentric discriminant analysis. I recall the discrete method. You cut in class numerical expected variables. You construct the complete disjunctive table K ij of all expected variables. You do correspondence analysis of this table and you visualize explicative modalities and modalities to explain. After, you do discriminant factorial analysis on the factor of this analysis in keeping the factor associated to a fixed inertia percentage, for example, 80 or 19%, and which are discriminant. The score of an individual I is the abscess of the projection of I on the factorial discriminant axis with the inertia metric. Variant, barycentric discriminant analysis, the first step are the same. Third step, construction of the table K, CJ, G, crossing the C of the two modalities of the variable Y to be explained, with the set G of all the explicative modalities. Question analysis of this table with K, IG in supplementary, and visualization of explicative modalities and modalities to explain. Projection on the single axis of the precedent analysis and after classic discrimination. These two methods are very near, and we do here the comparison in these two methods. If in this code analysis we keep all the factors, we obtain the same discriminant analysis as in the space of explicative modalities than in barycentric discriminant analysis. It is the axis joining the barycenters of the two modalities to be foreseen. But the scores are not the same. In the first case, we project the individuals with the inertia metric, which correspond to work on the factor on J of variance 1. In the second case, we use the key metric coming from correspondence analysis. And you work on the usual factor, it is the factor of eigenvalue variance. Remarks, we can finally notice that instead of doing factorial discriminant analysis, we can also proceed to the logistic regression on the factors coming from correspondence analysis. Barycentric discriminant analysis and discrete method can easily be generalized to the case where the variable to explain Y has more than two modalities. Third example, Moreno and Alteri, 1994. Problem, forcing the journal cell quantity of a certain number of wholesalers with a better accuracy than the one provided by the expert. The table of data, KIT, gives the total cell of the wholesaler I in the week T. Solution in three phases. First, do correspondence analysis of the line profiles table of the table KIT. after you do an ascendant hierarchy classification defining Wurzeler classes. After, second, for each class C, you do principal comparison analysis, you apply the reconstitution formula, it's the second step, and in the formula of reconstitution, MC of T is the mean of key of KIT in class C, and FC1I and FC2I are coordinates of I on the two first partial axes. Third step, we modelize MCT, UC1T and UC2T by a box linking procedure, ici, by a CERIMA process. To end, some words on correspondence analysis and data analysis since 2000, very quickly. We have the links between correspondence analysis, data analysis and data mining, with the GRIST database, complex data, etc. Connection between data analysis and statistical learning communities, with in particular the symposium SLDS in Paris-Dauphine in April 2009. ACT have been published in Modular Review. Extension or interesting methodologies based on factor analysis have been developed in the framework of sensorial analysis, which took a good importance since few years. Important use of PLS regression, for example, the case of near infrared spectroscopy data in kinetic control, development of PLS approach, PLS modeling, etc. One remark to end. Factual methods and data analysis are not enough used in France, but they could provide great help in numerous cases to users having databases every day, more important and complex. The bibliography. Thank you for your attention.